I'm really nervous, but I'm excited.
Carrie Kopp suffers from a hereditary life-threatening kidney disease. Today, Carrie's life will forever change with the latest knowledge, skill, and technology of a dedicated UCLA transplant team and a priceless gift from her loving family.
Carrie discovered she had inherited her father's polycystic kidneys when she was 20. And she always knew that at some point her kidneys would fail. The cysts get large, they burst, and she has kidney stone-like pain. For anyone who's ever had kidney stones, they know that this is excruciating.
The kidneys clean the blood. They filter the blood and then produce urine to get rid of the waste. When your kidneys start to fail, toxins build up in your blood. You start to feel ill. You may have difficulty breathing.
And the kidneys are responsible for maintaining the inside environment of our bodies in a stable state. Because if the inside environment of our bodies are not in a stable state, our cells and our organs don't function properly. And that means we have to have the right number of salts and water in the body, and it's a very delicate balancing act.
If everybody going into kidney failure was able to get a transplant, I think that would be our choice of therapy for because having a kidney transplant gives you back normal kidney function. I think the exciting thing about transplantation is how successful it's become. The main problem, of course, is just the difference between supply and demand, that we have approaching 750,000 people on dialysis in a few years to come, 70,000 people on the waiting list, and we only do 10,000 to 12,000 kidney transplants a year.
Of those national figures, UCLA is a leading transplant center, performing nearly 300 kidney transplants every year. Carrie is one of the lucky ones. She will receive a kidney from her brother.
When I think about having this kidney, I think about the energy and the stamina and just being able to live a normal life without dialysis and without feeling so exhausted. And I feel like I don't remember what it feels like to feel good anymore, almost, you know?
Well, Carrie and David are an exceptional brother and sister pair. If you ever meet them, you'll know that they have a particular chemistry right off the bat.
I just thought that they should have a little note from me in the operating room. So here we go.
Carrie was a very outgoing person, but she inherited disease. It's been in her family. She was very tough, and she went along with it, but her kidneys became massively enlarged to the point that they were very painful.
Yeah, I wear like a size 2, but my stomach's 35 inches.
Eventually, the kidney started to fail, and she started to become very weak.
It was just a given. You know, when she needed it, she needed a kidney, and mine were healthy, that she could have one of mine. It's not a decision. You know, it wasn't a question, what should I do? When you have a kind of closeness and, you know, that we have, but I can't imagine it being any other way with my sister. In fact, I've said to her, I said, I expect you to expect it from me. So it's very strange when people say you're doing something very heroic and you're doing something so great for your sister, and I don't perceive it that way at all, not at all.
We have so many people in this country who die waiting for organs, and especially in the case of kidney transplants, we all have two, and we really function very beautifully on one.
I am thankful, of course I'm thankful, but I'm just thankful to have him as my brother.
One of the biggest advances in kidney transplantation at UCLA is the way the kidney can be retrieved from living donors like David.
I think the biggest change has been the introduction of the laparoscopic donor nephrectomy. Because of the benefits of transplantation, more and more people are considered good candidates for a kidney transplant. And we simply don't have enough kidneys to go around for everyone. So more and more people have come forward to donate a kidney. And this laparoscopic approach has allowed them to donate with very little pain and suffering. We place small instruments into the abdominal cavity through ports, which are sort of like straws. And we have very small television cameras and instruments which then go through those ports and into the abdominal cavity. Using the television camera to see what is happening in the inside of the body, we can divide the ureter and then the blood vessels. In order to extract the kidney, we make a small incision over the pubic bone. And this allows us to remove the kidney through a small incision in an area of the body that's not too painful.
The good news is that transplants are very, very successful. The rates of success are excellent. We are achieving 90-95% success. The kidneys are lasting a long time. We're doing more and more transplants from living donors. Patients do have to take medications, but these days the medications are getting easier to deal with and the complication rates are diminished.
Dr. Peter Shulam and his team remove David's left kidney through this minimally invasive laparoscopic technique and take the kidney into Carrie's operating room, where her kidneys are being removed. Doctors normally leave polycystic kidneys in place and add the donor organ. But Carrie's diseased kidneys are so enormous, they must come out to make room. They are many times their normal weight and covered in cysts. Dr. Gritch and his team meticulously sew David's small, healthy donor kidney into his sister, Carrie. Within minutes, it is working perfectly.
Because this is an inherited trait, she's fortunate that her disease will not reoccur in the transplant. So my hope for Carrie is that she will have a good kidney function for many years to come. We hope that she can have a normal life now.
6 weeks later, Carrie, like thousands of UCLA organ recipients before her, is on the mend and prepares for a new life ahead.
I think the most significant advance for the public is that transplantation has become extraordinarily safe and successful. Half the live donor transplants such as Carrie received will last at least 20 years, which really is quite outstanding. A kidney transplant really does give you a completely new lease on life.
For us, I know in our business, doctors, nurses, all of us, nothing gives us more gratification than facilitating a successful family or living donor transplant. It is very gratifying, and it's a delight to see how well Carrie is doing.
I am feeling so much better. It's really been amazing. So I really think that it's just a matter of time before, you know, kidneys are lasting the rest of people's lives instead of, you know, 5, 10, 20 years. They're just lasting forever. I have all the confidence that these kinds of developments are just going to continue. There's so much time and effort spent by these amazing doctors to do that. So it's a great thing. It's really amazing. It's very, very miraculous.